Dear students, in this lecture, we will study helium neon laser. Helium neon laser is the first gas laser which was developed. It is a four-level gaseous laser as compared to ruby laser. Ruby laser was a three-level laser. Helium neon laser is a four-level laser. The mixture of helium and neon gases are taken in the ratio 10:1. And they are filled in the discharge tube. Here, helium gas is used as active medium and neon gas is used as active material. Here, discharge tube is used as pumping process by means of imbibing inelastic atomic collisions method. The power output is approximately 0.5 to 50 milliwatts. The output light is continuous wave. The principle of this helium neon laser. We already know that the active medium is the helium neon gas. The gas laser medium is excited by electric discharge method, in which inelastic collision between atoms will result in population inversion process. This is the schematic diagram of helium neon laser. Now let us look at the construction of helium neon laser. Helium neon laser consists of quartz discharge tube. It is about 80 cm long and 1.5 cm in diameter. The discharge tube is filled with mixture of helium and neon gases with different partial pressures. The gases are mixed under the pressure of 1 millimeter of mercury of helium and 0.1 millimeter mercury of neon. 0.1 millimeter mercury of neon in the ratio of 10:1. These mixtures acts as active material. That means helium and neon gases are taken in the ratio 10:1. The ends of the discharge tube are inclined at the polarizing angle. Hence, the emitted laser light is plane polarized. This arrangement is called Brewster window. A radio frequency generator or RF generator is connected to the discharge tube. It is used to produce population inversion in active material. A pair of concave mirror is placed at the ends of discharge tube. One of the mirrors is 100% reflecting. This one is 100% reflecting concave mirror. And the other is partially reflecting. This one is partially reflecting mirror. These mirrors form an optical resonator. These two mirrors combine to form an optical resonator. Now we will see the working of this helium neon laser. When RF generator is switched on, electrons are generated inside the discharge tube. At first, the generated electrons collide with helium atoms in ground state. Thereby, helium atoms are excited to two off energy levels as shown in figure. This is the energy level diagram of helium neon ions. This energy level diagram is for helium and this is for neon. Helium has ground state here, two excited states, 2s state and 3s state. Neon has ground state in the same value of energy and it has excited states 2p, 3p, 2s and 3s. Where 3s, 2s of helium atom states and neon atomic states are at the same energy values. These two levels happen to be very close to the 3s and 2s levels of the neon atoms. That means the excited two excited states of helium atoms are nearly at the 3s and 2s levels of the neon atoms as shown in the diagram. when the excited helium atoms collide with the neon atoms, energy is exchanged, pumping the neon atoms to the respective levels. Whenever we switch on the RF generator, electrons are generated inside the discharge tube. They will collide with the helium atoms in ground state, and this helium atom in ground state will be transit to the excited state. There it will collide with the neon atoms. Their energy is exchanged. By this, neon atoms will grab that energy from excited helium atom and they will go to the respective excited states, that is 3s and 2s states. The atoms at the neon 3s level eventually drops down to the 2p level. As a result, stimulated emission is taking place and light of wavelength 0.6328 micrometer is emitted. From this 3s state to 2p state, there is a stimulated emission process by which a light of wavelength 6328 angstrom is emitted. The atoms at the 2s level, on the other hand, drops to the 2p level by emitting light at 1.15 micrometer. That means atoms at 2s level will come to 2p level by emitting a light of wavelength 1.15 micrometer. However, the atoms at the 3s level may instead drop to the 3p level by emitting light of 3.39 micrometer. That means from 3s, atoms may come down to 3p level by emitting a light of wavelength 3.39 micrometers. By this way, we will get laser light of different wavelengths using helium neon laser. By looking at this energy level diagram, we can see that this is a 4 level laser. That means 3s and 2s are the excited states, 3p and 2p are the another excited states. There are 4 energy levels, therefore we can say it is a 4 level laser. Now we will see the advantages of helium neon laser. Less heat is generated inside the discharge tube, therefore no need for cooling. It is operated in continuous mode. It has high stability of wavelength. Output of the laser can be tuned to a required wavelength, plus or minus 100 angstroms. And it is not much expensive. Some of the disadvantages of helium neon laser are: output power is moderate. In compare with solid state laser, its size is large. This is all about helium neon laser.